feels like it gets in the way. Hanging up, but we got nothing to say. See you tomorrow, love you through sorrow. Leave me some breadcrumbs and I swear I'll follow you.
Dinner in a gas station? Why not? Let's do that thing. I've heard El Carajo restaurant talked about for so long and I never gave it a shot. So I figured, let's do it. We needed some gas, we were kind of hungry. It just made sense. When you walk in there, it looks like a normal gas station. You want to pay for cigarettes, you want a lighter, you want some kind of Snickers bar, you could buy that. But you start to look in the back and you start to become curious. What's so cool about this place is that the bottles are at cost. So basically what you would buy them for in total wine or something like that, you get them for that cost. They throw a couple dollars on top, but you're saving so much. It's a real cool European vibe when you walk back there too. The place is decorated awesome. The paintings are great. They really transport you to another place. It gets you ready for the delicious food that you're about to enjoy. To start off with, caldo gallego. It's smoked pork, sausage, bacon, bok choy, serrano ham, and white beans. What a delicious soup. Such deep, rich, developed flavors with that luscious, velvety bean. It goes so, so beautifully. Next in line, the pulpo al ajillo. That's a chef's reinvention of a Spanish favorite. Has octopus with golden brown sauteed garlic and a secret blend of spices. You get this potatoes that are just boiled with a little bit of salt on top, and you get loads of that pimentón flavor, kind of like a smoked paprika essence, served with some bubbles to wash it down. It just clears up your palate and gets you ready for that next bite. And let's face it, I mean, who doesn't like a nice bubbly experience in the middle of the week, because I definitely do. The service staff was friendly, informative, and attentive. It just really complements the experience. Delicious food, delicious drink, good service. Makes you want to keep ordering more, like we did with the calamares frito, the fried squid in a blend of seasonings served with a tomato shellfish sauce. There was two different types. I'm not 100% sure what the other one was. I think it was some kind of mayonnaise-based version of the other one, but I went with both of them. Fried stuff, you know, I love it. Fried seafood, huge fan of it. Calamari and octopus is pretty much always a go as far as I'm concerned. But one of the main events that my girl brought me in there for was the bacon wrapped dates. And don't get me wrong, I'm in the mood for them once in a while. It was great that it caught me off guard though, because when I took that bite, I was expecting the sweetness of the date with the richness of the bacon, but there was a little surprise in there. They mixed in a little chorizo as well, added another layer of flavor, and it's more complex as you move on. It sticks with you and it makes you think about that bite and makes you want to order another round, maybe two, depending on who you're with. Tapas places are always kind of dangerous because they're smaller plates and you just keep ordering pretty much everything on the menu. You have a bite or two, you get another dish, you get another one, and you keep going. But watch out, these things are crazy hot, burn the roof of your mouth type hot. This place was so fun. I'm so happy that I gave it a shot. If you're in the area, you need to stop in. Grab yourself a couple bottles to take home with you, grab yourself a nice experience in the back, and make sure that you really let yourself go and kind of submit to the experience, because it's just another example on how you could find great stuff pretty much anywhere. Thanks again for watching, everybody. You keep watching, I'ma keep hunting, and I'ma see you soon, okay?